All right, so today's class is on quotient rule. In the previous class, we did product rule of differentiation. Now we are going to do quotient rule. If you have a function that is expressed as a fraction, now what do I mean by expressed as a fraction? It has an expression in the numerator and an expression in the denominator. So let's take an example of y equals to 2x plus 1 over 6x plus 2, the whole thing square. If this is our function that is expressed as a fraction, then you're going to differentiate this by applying the quotient rule. This is your quotient rule. Dy by dx of this function is going to be vu prime minus uv prime over v square. Now, your u is going to be the numerator and the v is going to be the denominator in this case. If I differentiate u, I'm going to get 2. If I differentiate v, I'm going to get 2 times 6x plus 2. You're going to reduce the power by 1. Multiply by the differentiation of this bracket, which is 6. So this is going to result in 12 times 6x plus 2. Now I have u prime as well and v prime as well. Quotient rule says vu prime. So 6x plus 2, the whole thing square, times by u prime, which is 2, minus u, which is 2x plus 1, times v prime, which is 12 times 6x plus 2, divided by v square. So v was 6x plus 2 square. This is going to be squared up. And you can simplify this as much as you can. So this is how you're going to apply the quotient rule. The denominator is always going to be your v, and the numerator is always going to be your u. You're going to differentiate the numerator and the denominator and apply this quotient rule. Quotient rule is vu prime minus uv prime over v square. Vu prime minus uv prime over v square. Okay, let's take one more example. Let's say my function is x cubed plus 1 upon 2x minus 3. Okay, over here. Use the quotient rule to find the derivative of y equals to x cubed plus 1 over 2x minus 3. So what is the numerator in this case? The numerator is going to be
x cubed
plus 1, and the denominator is going to be 2x minus 3. If I differentiate u, what will I get?
3x squared.
And the differentiation of v is going to be
2.
Now, since I have to apply quotient rule, which is vu prime minus uv prime over v square. V is 2x minus 3. U prime is 3x squared. Minus u is x cubed plus 1, and v prime is 2 divided by v square, 2x minus 3, the whole thing square. Now you can simplify this further. 6x cubed minus 9x squared minus 2x cubed minus 2 over 2x minus 3, the whole thing square. The result is going to be 4x cubed minus 9x squared minus 2 over 2x minus 3, the whole thing square. I can't simplify this further, so this is where I will stop. Dy by dx is going to be equal to 4x cubed minus 9x squared minus 2 upon 2x minus 3, the whole thing square. Is the application of quotient rule understood?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Now I'm going to see this. Find the derivative of x plus 1, the whole thing square, over square root of x plus 2. So my u is going to be x plus 1, the whole thing square, and my v is going to be x plus 2, square root of x plus 2. I can write this square root of x plus 2 as x plus 2 to the power of half. Now I want you to help me out in differentiating u. So what is going to be the differentiation of u? What is u prime?
2x plus 2.
2x.
2x plus 1, reduce the power by 1, times the differentiation of the inside bracket, that is 1. So yes, 2 times x plus 1. What is v prime? 1 upon 2, x plus 2 to the power of? What is going to be the power of x plus 2?
1 upon 2.
Half minus 1 is minus 1 upon 2. Multiply by 1, the differentiation of the inside, so it is going to be the same thing. Now dy by dx is going to be v u prime minus u v prime over v square. We need to be careful in solving and simplifying this. So I'm going to write this as clearly as possible. V is x plus 2 to the power of half. U prime is 2 times x plus 1 minus u is x plus 1 the whole thing squared. V prime is 1 upon 2 x plus 2 to the power of minus half divided by v square. So what is v square going to be over here? It was x plus 2 to the power of half, and this is going to be squared. So what does v square simplifies to?
X plus 2.
X plus 2, yes. So the denominator will be x plus 2 only to the power of 1. Now, let's simplify the numerator as well. I'm simplifying the numerator first over here. 2 times x plus 1 times x plus 2 to the power of half minus 1 upon 2 x plus 1 the whole thing square. Now, this x plus 2 to the power of minus half can be written in the denominator part as x plus 2 to the power of positive half, right? Is this step clear? X plus 2 to the power of minus half can be written as 1 upon x plus 2 to the power of half. Divided by x plus 2. I'm going to do the rest of the working on the right-hand side. Now you can simplify this numerator by making these denominators same. Okay. So over here, this is going to be 2x plus 2 to the power of half. So I will have to multiply, iske denominator mein 1 hai, I'll have to multiply this with x plus 2 to the power of half. Notice this, that 2 times x plus 1 times x plus 2 to the power of half times x plus 2 to the power of half is going to be x plus 2 to the power of 1. Are you all getting it? Minus, yes. X plus 1 squared. The entire thing was being divided by x plus 2. Are you all with me till here? Is there any step that isn't clear? Please let me know.
Sir, could you explain how you got it to the power 1 again?
Power 1 for this? X plus 2?
Yeah, that.
Okay, just focus on the numerator. Okay? The numerator is itself in fractional form. So I need to make the denominator of this numerator common. Okay? So the LCM of the numerator, just this part, see the highlighted part. The numerator of the denominator of this highlighted part is going to be 2x plus 2 to the power of half. So if the denominator has 1, I will have to multiply this 1 by x plus 2 to the power of half. I will have to multiply this with 2. Sorry. I'll have to multiply this with 2 times x plus 2 to the power of half. So 2 times 2 is going to be 4. X plus 1 as it is. What is x plus 2 to the power of half times x plus 2 to the power of half?
X plus 2.
X plus 2 to the power of 1. Then minus 1 times x plus 1, the whole thing square. Okay. So far I have done this. Now, you can see that x plus 1 is present over here as well, and over here as well. I can take x plus 1 common out. If I take x plus 1 common out, inside the bracket, I'm going to be left with 4 times x plus 2 minus x plus 1. The whole thing is being divided by 2 times x plus 2 to the power of half. Now, what will happen to this divide x plus 2? Can I reciprocate it and write multiply by 1 upon x plus 2? Can I do that?
Yes, sir.
So now this is x plus 2 to the power of half, and this is x plus 2 to the power of 1. When the bases are same and are being multiplied, powers are going to be
added.
So 2 times x plus 2 to the power of what's half plus 1? 3 over 2. You can simplify the numerator now. 4x plus 8 minus x minus 1. X plus 1. 4x minus x is 3x plus 8 minus 1 is 7 over 2 times x plus 2 to the power of 3 over 2. You can leave your answer over here. Okay? This is the final answer. Any questions still here?
No, sir.
All right. If you want to note it down, you can. Let me know when you're done.
Sure, I'm done.
Okay. So the next question is, find the gradient of the curve y equals to 7x minus 2 over 2x plus 3 at the point where the curve crosses the y-axis. So I don't know yet how will the curve look like, but I need to find the gradient of this curve at a point where the curve crosses the y-axis. Let's say the curve crosses the y-axis at this point. I am only interested in finding the gradient at this point. So if the curve crosses the y-axis, would you agree that the x-coordinate is going to be 0?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So the x-coordinate of this point P, let me call this point P, the x-coordinate is going to be 0. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to find the gradient function. To find the gradient, I need to have the gradient function. And to find the gradient function, I look at the function itself, and this function is written as a fraction. So for finding dy by dx of this function, I will have to go for quotient rule. So I'm going to do the same drill again. U is 7x minus 2, v is 2x plus 3, u prime is going to be 7, and v prime is going to be 2. Dy by dx is going to be vu prime minus uv prime over v square. V is 2x plus 3. U prime is 7, minus u is 7x minus 2, and v prime is 2, divided by v square, which is 2x plus 3, the whole thing square. If you want to simplify, you can, but it's not mandatory over here because we just have to plug in the value and get the final answer out. But I'll do the simplification. 7 times 2 is 14x plus 21, minus 14x, plus 4. So 21 plus 4, 25 over 2x plus 3, the whole thing squared. Referring back to the question just asked to find me the gradient. Find the gradient of the curve at the point where the curve crosses the y-axis. So I know that the point where the curve is going to cross the y-axis will have the x coordinate 0. So technically they want you to find the gradient of the curve at x equals to 0. So when you're going to plug in x as 0, would you get 25 over 9?
Yes.
So the gradient is positive and the value is 25 over 9. Okay, try the next question by yourself. First, you can copy this down, copy the working, note down the working, and then you can try with question number 7. All right, students, done.
No.
Okay. Take your time, no worries. Okay. Is everyone clear with the first step? V u prime minus u v prime over v square. Right?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
If I take two common from here and simplify it with half, I'm just going to have x minus 5. And I can write x plus 1 to the power of positive half in the denominator. And all of this is going to be divided by x plus 1. If I just make the denominators common, this is going to be x plus 1 to the power of half. So the left term is going to be 2 times x plus 1 minus x minus 5 divided by x plus 1. If I simplify this further, I'm going to get 2x plus 2 minus x plus 5 over x plus 1 to the power of, what is going to be the combined power of x plus 1? If you reciprocate this term and multiply this term with this, what is going to be x plus 1 to the power? Would you agree that it is going to be 3 upon 2?
Yes, because we're adding the powers.
So x plus 7 over x plus 1 to the power of 3 upon 2. Now you can set it equal to 5 upon 4. Solve it from here. Okay? I'm going to continue after the exam. All right. I think it's difficult to simplify this. It will result in a cubic equation first, and then we are expected to solve the cubic equation. So in your exam, you might not get this to this difficulty level because when us mein pura hi time nikal jaye. But let me show you kahan tak hum kar sakte hain isko. So if you cross multiply this, you're going to get 5 times x plus 1 to the power of 3 upon 2 equals to 4 times x plus 7. So you would agree with me that in order to remove the square root, I'll have to square both sides. If I do that, I'm going to get 25 times x plus 1 cubed. This is going to be 16 times x plus 7, the whole thing squared. Okay. Now, x plus 1 cubed is nothing but x plus 1 times x plus 1, the whole thing squared. See? I think I have to leave it over here. If I will expand this, I'll multiply it with this. You're going to get a cubic equation at the end. Say it. And if you just recall, cubic equation, other simple cubic equation, we would solve. We go for trial and error. Ek factor nikalte the, and then we go for long division. Aur phir is tarike se hum roots nikalte the, theek hai? So the method is going to be this. But right now I'm not going to solve this because it will take a lot of time. So yeah, once you are done with the, once you get the cubic equation, you can just for this question, you can use the online tools to find the x value and the corresponding y value. You're going to plug in the cubic equation into the online tool, any online tool to solve it, and you're going to get the x and y values. So is it okay if I move on now? But you get the idea, right? You get the idea of equating,
yes,
finding the code,
yes,
finding the dy by dx expression and equating it to the gradient given. All right. So the next concept that we are going to discuss now is the concept of tangent and normal. What you see in front of you is a curve. This function, and this function can be any function, but I have taken here an example of 2x squared plus 5x. So if you are asked to find, you could be asked to find the equation of the tangent at point A and the equation of the normal at point A. Now, a tangent line is a line that crosses point A at only one point. It does not intersect the curve anywhere else. Okay, so that this is our tangent line. To find the equation of the tangent, we need point A and we need the gradient at point A. So what do we do is we differentiate the function to find dy by dx expression. Once we have this dy by dx expression, we are going to plug in the x coordinate of A and find the gradient at point A. Once I know the gradient at point A, to find, this is going to give me the gradient of the tangent. Now, for example, the gradient comes out to be 2. So the gradient of the normal, a normal line is a line that is perpendicular to the tangent. The gradient of the normal is going to be taken out using this formula, this equation. Gradient of the tangent times the gradient of the normal is always equal to minus 1. So if the gradient of the tangent and the product of the gradient of the tangent and the gradient of the normal is always equal to minus 1. And if I'm telling you that the gradient of a tangent comes out to be 2, then you don't need to calculate the normal again. You can just use this equation and find the gradient of the normal, which will come out to be minus 1 upon 2. The curve, the tangent, and the normal all are passing through point A. So So if I were to find the equation of the tangent, I'm going to use point A and the gradient of the tangent. And if I want to find the equation of the normal, I'm going to use point A and the gradient of the normal. Okay. And how do we find the equation of straight lines? Y minus Y1 equals to MX minus X1. Or you could simply do Y equals to MX plus C. So I'll do the entire question with an example. Okay. So if the function is 2x squared plus 5x, what is going to be the gradient? Sorry, I got disconnected. Can you all hear me now?
Yes, sir.
All right. Let me know when the screen gets visible. All right. Is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So I was doing this example before I got disconnected. So if we find the grade differentiation of the function 2x squared plus 5x, I'm going to get f prime of x is going to be 4x plus 5. This is the gradient expression, or the, you can say that the gradient function. So in order to find the gradient at point A, gradient of the tangent at point A, I'm going to plug in 3 because A has a coordinate of 3, 2. So I'm going to plug in 3 in my gradient function. After plugging 3 in the gradient function, I get 17. 4 times 3 is 12, 12 plus 5 is 17. So gradient of the tangent comes out to be 17. Now I have the gradient and I know the point A, 3, 2. Can I just use the equation of a straight line to find the equation of the tangent?
Sir, can you explain that again?
So y minus y1. Yeah, sure. What do I need to explain again? Which part?
So the last part where you said if the equation of the straight line is enough.
Okay, so the equation of a straight line can be found by using this equation y minus y1 equals to m times x minus x1. If I know the gradient of the tangent and I know one point, I can easily find the equation of equation of the tangent. So the gradient of the tangent is 17. Are you all aware of this form to find the equation of a line? Or you are more comfortable using y equals to mx plus c?
Sir, I'm comfortable with both the forms.
Both the forms. Okay. So I'm going to use the point 3, 2, and I'm going to use the gradient 17 to find the equation of the tangent. Y minus y1, y1 is 2, gradient is 17, x minus 3. If you simplify this, you are going to get this equation of the tangent. Okay. Now the second task is to find the equation of the normal. If I know the gradient of the tangent, I can find the gradient of the normal by using this equation mt into mn equals to minus 1. The gradient of the tangent times the gradient of the normal will always be equal to negative 1. So if my tangent gradient is 17, then the gradient of the normal will come out to be minus 1 upon 17. Right?
Yes.
So can I also say that the normal line is also passing through the same point A? If the normal line is also passing through the same point A, then I am going to use point A coordinates that are 3, 2, and the gradient of the normal that is minus 1 upon 17, and use the equation of a line y minus y1 equals to m x minus x1 to find the equation of the line. So y minus 2 equals to minus 1 upon 17 times x minus 3. All right. So if you simplify this, you're going to get this equation of normal. And this was equation of tangent. Are we clear till here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us try this question. Find the equation of the tangent at the normal and the curve.
Sir, can you go back to that slide for 1 minute? Done, sir. You can move on.
All right. Find the equation of the tangent and the normal to the curve y equals to 3x squared minus x plus 8 upon x. Now, this is not a quadratic equation. This equation represents any curve. We need to find the equation of the tangent and the equation of the normal at this point x equals to 2. So the idea is going to be same. I have a curve. I know the point. That point, I can label this point as P. I just know the x coordinate. First of all, I'm going to find the equation of the tangent. And then I can find the equation of the normal. You can first find the gradient of the tangent and the gradient of the normal as well. So do I know the exact point P or I just know the x coordinate?
Just the x coordinate.
Just the x coordinate. How can I find the y coordinate?
By plugging in the value of x coordinate.
I don't have the equation of the normal. What do I have? Can I use equation of the curve to find the y coordinate?
Yes,
since
sir.
This point is also lying on the curve. Yeah. So the y coordinate comes out to be 14. Now you can differentiate this to find the gradient expression. The gradient expression is going to come out as 6x minus 1 minus 8 over x squared. Please confirm.
Yeah, sir, it's coming that.
Okay. Moving on. So I know the gradient function now. I need to find the gradient of the tangent. So I'm going to plug in x as 2 in the function. 6 times 2 minus 1 minus 8 upon 2 square. 6 times 2 is 12 minus 1. 8 upon 4 is 2. So I'm getting 9. Will this be the gradient of the tangent or the gradient of the normal? Or the gradient of the curve?
Tangent.
Kiska gradient hai ye? Curve ka hai, tangent wali line ka hai ya normal wali line ka hai?
Is it the tangent?
It's the gradient of the tangent curve, as well as the gradient of the curve at this point. So this represents the gradient of the curve at x equals to 2. Also,
sir,
it is the gradient. Yes.
Is the tangent of the curve and the gradient always the same?
Yes. Okay. Gradient of the tangent and gradient of the curve at the point is always the same. Okay. So this is the gradient of the tangent. To find the gradient of the normal, what will I do? Gradient of the normal times the gradient of the tangent is always equal to
minus one.
So gradient of the normal will be minus 1/9. Achha. Ab you have the gradient of the tangent and you have this point P. You can find the equation of tangent and equation of normal as well, because you have the gradient of the normal as well. So y minus y1 equals to m times x minus x1. Y minus y1 is 14. The gradient comes out to be 9 x minus x1. Y minus 14 equals to 9x minus 18. Y equals to 9x minus 18 plus 14 is going to be minus 4. So this is the equation of the tangent. For the equation of the normal, I can use the same form of the equation. Y minus, the coordinates are going to be same, but the gradient is going to be minus 1/9. Also, I've seen marking scheme where you can leave your answer over here as well if not asked to simplify further. Okay. If you want, you can. This is going to be 9y. What's 14 times 9? 126 minus x plus 2. 9y plus x equals to 128. Are we all on the same page?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is everyone clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, I have this question solved for you all, but I want you to try first on your own, and then you can refer to the solution and see if your coordinates of C matches with mine. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So do you all understand this question? Or do you want me to repeat once more?
Yes, sir.
What about you, Vaina?
Yes, sir, I understand.
Sir, but I have one question.
Sure.
Sir, when do we take out equations for anything?
In the first part, you are being asked to find the coordinate of C. And the question says that the tangent and the normal meet at point C.
Okay.
The question says the normal to the curve at point A and the normal to the curve at point B meets at C. So we will have to find the normal equation of normals at both point A and B so that later onwards we can solve the equation of the normals to find the point of intersection. Is this sound clear?
Yes, sir.
Like, pehle aap point A pe normal ki equation nikalenge, point B pe normal ki equation nikalenge, then on dono equations ko simultaneously solve karenge, tab jaake point C ke coordinates aayenge. So your question was, okay, how do we know if you want to find the equation of normal or equation of tangent? So in this, equation of tangent was not important to me because point C is the intersection of the normal, not the tangent. So I'm going to get rid of, I'm just going to find the equation of, I'm just going to find the gradient of the tangent at point A and gradient of the tangent at point B. Taake phir main m1 into m2 equals to minus 1 use karke normal ka gradient at point A or normal ka gradient at point B find kar sakun. Jab normal ka gradient aa jayega aur mere paas point A or point B hai to main normal ki equations bana lunga aur dono ko simultaneously solve karke point C ke coordinates aa jayenge. That's the idea. Is this clear?
Okay. Yes, sir. Then how will we find the area of the triangle then?
Okay. Are three of you done with this coordinate of C? Okay. Now, to find the area of the triangle ABC. Now, we don't know what shape, like what type of triangle ABC is. You can't just visualize by this. Although you have the coordinates of C, one way is going to be that you plot these coordinates A, B, C. Ab agar wo right angle triangle nahi hai, to phir kya karoge? Theek hai? So the best approach is the shoestring formula. Do you remember shoestring formula, Vaina? Aapne mere saath kiya tha.
Yes, I remember.
This is the shoestring formula. Kashish and Renu, do you know this?
Yes, sir.
So I'm just going to repeat once more. You write down the coordinates of A, you write down the coordinates of B and the coordinates of C, and you repeat the coordinate of A again. Then you multiply diagonally. So this is our primary diagonal going from top left to bottom right. This is our primary diagonal. So the product of 4 into 0, 0. Plus 1 times minus 2, minus 2, plus minus 7 times minus 3, plus 21 ho jata. Minus the product of secondary diagonal, which is minus 3 times 1, plus minus 7 times 0, plus minus 2 times 4. Okay? Then you can simplify this and you are going to get 30 in this mod sign. There is a mod sign attached because the area cannot be negative. So if you would have got minus 30, then you are going to write down plus 30 because the area is not negative. Then you times it by half. So the area comes out to be 15. So the area of ABC triangle is going to be 15 unit square. Okay?
Okay, yeah.
Okay, let's try this question. A curve has an equation y equals to x cubed minus x plus 6. Find the equation of the tangent to this curve at this point. So to find the equation of the tangent, I first need the gradient of the tangent, for which I need the gradient expression. Okay. I'm going to find dy by dx, which is the gradient of the tangent at point minus 1. So this is going to be 2. So the gradient of the tangent comes out to be 2. Using the equation y minus y1 equals to m times x minus x1. This is my equation of the tangent. 2x plus 8. Please let me know if you have any questions so far.
It's clear, sir.
Okay. Now the next statement is the tangent at the point Q is parallel to the tangent at point P. Do we remember that parallel lines have the same gradient?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The tangent at point P and tangent at point Q are parallel, then that means that the gradient is same. So the gradient is going to be same. So I think for the second part, I know the dy by dx expression. Dy by dx expression is 3x squared minus 1. I want the same gradient, which means that the gradient should be 2. The gradient of the tangent at point P was coming out to be 2. So the gradient of the tangent at point Q must also be equated to 2. So 3x squared minus 1 must be equal to 2. So 3x squared must be equal to 3. X squared must be equal to 1. And that's why x must be equal to plus minus 1. So see, one of the coordinate of P was minus 1. So what is going to be the coordinate of Q? What is going to be the x coordinate of Q?
One.
It's going to be 1. Sahi hai? Ye baat clear hai sabko?
Yeah, sir.
X equals to plus minus 1 value jab aa rahi thi jab aapne gradient ko 2 ke equal kiya. Ab gradient ko 2 ke equal, iska matlab hai ki ye jo curve hai, it is passing through point P as well and point Q as well. और दोनों पॉइंट्स पे सेम ग्रेडियंट है, दोनों पॉइंट्स पे सेम ग्रेडियंट है. सो वन वैल्यू, इफ अगर मैंने ग्रेडियंट एक्सप्रेशन इक्वल टू 2 रख के एक्स की वैल्यूज निकाली हैं, सो आई एम गेटिंग टू वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स, वन इज प्लस 1, वन इज माइनस 1. आई नो इन द क्वेश्चन दैट माइनस 1 इज द एक्स वैल्यू फॉर पी, सो क्यू के लिए क्या होगी? इट्स गोइंग टू बी प्लस 1. नाउ हाउ डू आई फाइंड द वाई कोऑर्डिनेट?
Sir, why can't it be minus 1 again?
It can't be minus 1 again because basically P and Q lies on the curve. Sahi hai? Let's say ye point P hai aur ye point Q hai. If I draw the tangent, this is the tangent at point P and this is the tangent at point Q. These two are parallel lines. The tangent at P and the tangent at point Q are parallel lines. So obviously they can't be the same point. If this is given to me in the question as minus 1, 6, minus 1 hai, so Q ke coordinates 1 aa rahe hain meri calculation ke mutabik. I know that the gradient was 2. So iska bhi gradient 2 hoga. So maine dy by dx ko 2 ke equal kiya and I'm getting two values of x jahan pe gradient can be 2. So, एक वैल्यू तो माइनस वन है, दूसरी वैल्यू 1 है. सो क्यूब के कोऑर्डिनेट्स क्या होंगे? 1, व्हाटएवर. अब मैं क्यू के कोऑर्डिनेट कैसे निकाल सकता हूँ? वाई कोऑर्डिनेट कैसे निकालूंगा?
सिर्फ 1 डाल के इन द इक्वेशन.
कहाँ पे? विच इक्वेशन?
इक्वेशन ऑफ द कर्व.
इक्वेशन ऑफ द कर्व. सो 1, 6. 1, 6 is the coordinate of Q. Then the question says, find the equation of the normal at Q. Now I need to find the equation of the normal at Q. I have Q ke coordinate. Can I have the gradient of the normal at Q? What is going to be the gradient of the normal at point Q?
-1/2.
-1/2. इसमें तो कोई किसी को कोई इशू नहीं है ना, कोई मसला नहीं है.
नहीं.
Because gradient of the tangent was 2, so the gradient of the normal is going to be -1/2. Y minus y1, which is 6. M times x minus x1. So 2y minus 12 equals to minus x plus 1. 2y plus x equals to 13. This is the equation of normal at Q. सही है?
जी सर.
या सर.
यस सर.
I want you to take a screenshot of this question and try this question for the next class. That is tomorrow.
Okay, sir.
Okay, okay, sir. I'll see you in the next.
Okay, sir.
Take care.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.